Hello, this is Dr. Justina Agnieszka Chevallier. This is about chapter number 7. As a reminder, it's a book entitled Non-Selective Survival versus Hyper-Selective Mating. And this is the book to be published through Charles in a Satori publishing and probably available, I'm thinking, on ResearchGate. Soon. Those videos are signed as synopsis, and this is synopsis of chapter 7. Chapter 7 is entitled Animals, Plants and Humans. Do I die if I kill to eat? And do I have to have sex? Do I have to have sex if I ate an offspring of another species? To offer own and that child's death, wedding and love rituals. And subtitle is How Many Camels for My Bride? How many bulls from my groom? Is there a deadline of love? We assume often that cycle of life and death, it's something that we do not have control over. And in Buddhism, for example, the liberation from that cycle through certain values is considered an achievement. To understand that this is not something that actually we do not have control over, we need to understand that killing any species results, while those species are suffering, in instinct to kill, as well as weakening diseases, and in a larger picture from the standpoint of epidemiology, wiping out of persons and species responsible for infliction of injuries, because no species can live in pain, or a chronic demise that in fact results in death. And understanding that leads to application of certain things to actually not to have phenomena such as sexual harassment, or what I call actually sanctionizing of a rape. What that is? Well, because we glorify work and education, and because sexual activity and traumas are not compatible, as I've mentioned in prior videos, with any other activity or interactions with other humans, we actually choose enforcing relationships that are second best or less to enable a system in which the sexual activity, number of children, is being non-stop while in a couple, deserved through labor or through money. And that is actually untrue, because it puts intermediaries. And because source of children are actually bodies of two persons, putting a third person brings disruption, especially when esteem or appreciation superior to the spouse chosen to marry is expected from authorities, from employers, and also provision of goods is superior from such, while based on work performance and evaluation of others' grades, of children as well, and their behavior, persons decide upon staying together or divorcing. And that is because settling is assumed as a prerequisite to marry, to enable forced labor while being married. And that is also sometimes done unilaterally. So we can talk about patriarchal and matriarchal systems, and that is an artificial, in fact, division. Why that is? Because there has to be two components present in a relationship to be able to sustain that relationship, only protecting what is natural law. And those two components are proven empirically, instinct to save an opposite gender person, a source of superior to others attachment and shared household, when such need occurs, first before all others, manifested as bodily impressions of anxiety or a pursuit of remediative actions to enable that person to perform again at a full health and full speed. And that is mutual. So often we assume, okay, so in patriarchal system the man is responsible for that while female expects it. And that brings disruption of that relationship, because often a co-worker, especially in professions that are highly in your demand on volunteering to sacrifice on own death pact to save others, such as firemen and firewomen, policemen and policewomen, doctors, males and females, as well as all of personnel of life and rescue, nursing personnel, and many other persons that actually volunteer to risk life. And it leads to a certain paradox that in a presence of a female that is most idealized in that patriarchal model and provided for, and the man is concerned with her safety, there is no reciprocity. So an example of that is a female that is based, stationed, that's an anecdote, on a military base while the husband performs active duties, and she's shielded and protected from all of those duties. And when, for example, that husband is kidnapped, she does not anymore have an instinct to save him, and given even in the geographic proximity a chance to pursue his well-being, she's substituted by females who work and usually are bound by semi or full celibacy vows. And then that brings primal rejection to that female spouse and reduction of that spouse to a child or to a person who's actually not quite as reliable in perception of that man worker as a mother, while there is no possibility, due to the fact how we actually build naturally relationships, to have a relationship with more than one person, more than one female. And so therefore there needs to be reciprocity, and that is not very well explained, especially to little girls. What does this mean? It means that a female, all of us, we function psychologically and physically the same as males. And that means that if the husband is in death threat or in pain, there is an instinct of a female who is sexual partner to protect and run to save the person first before everybody else, and derived from that also instinct to save first own children. And that is then, it has to be enabled, and couples are often, because of that prerequisite to form then a perception of safety, that sexual relationship is non-threatening, to have similar degree of preparation and responsiveness expressed in education and also in preparedness to have similar expectation and division of love and goods. And second extreme of that, what happens when I have luxury, which is having all of the money, who I would give the most? And if the answer is I would distribute it, being married, to others, or give it to someone else than the spouse, it means that I and that spouse, we do not have enough of so-called natural law to form nesting. So I do not have an instinct and do not count on reciprocity from that spouse, that he will keep that given money, or wish, as you know, best thing ever, that he is without, you know, skipped or omitted in sharing those, missed. And that has to be mutual. Again, if the other spouse, the male, has goods and given a chance to choose between male and a female, he will offer actually that first to the sexual partner on a basic instinct. That is proportional to the degree of pleasure, actually, this is not often mentioned, psychological and elevation, emotional elevation, intellectual one, expressed in bodily functional also arousal from one another as being source. And that is then patriarchal, matriarchal, depending on demands, in dynamic way relationship that has basis for wedding license. And children are most wanted, however, pursuit of children in vitro or adoption or a provision of non-stop services on contraceptives is simply not possible because of the degree of love, and that love is lasting. And then when that marriage is consummated, that forms a bond, which means if I have the best available and that person does, why would someone pursue someone that is less pleasurable, less source of gratification and less source of esteem? And this is mutual. And from that derived are bond, lifelong bond, and also love for children, as if it was a degree of emotions from a rainbow, like rainbow colors. You see, an instinct to save those children, and things like magic and explanations that are appropriate for children of adult relationships, and also that avoids typical to children vulgarity, because children materialize and place in scientific terms things that we cannot touch, emotionally express in words. And that is because children put still as superior mother or father, as opposed to a significant other, despite arousal, sexual arousal present in children. What is the difference? It's actually the innocence of that, is that there is no bonding attachment because of lack of capacity to have a child. And that is because the emotionally attachment is towards parents and towards elders and to caregivers, and not towards the children. And that is why the sexual education is derived from parents. Like I mentioned, like those colors of rainbow, or what is called inner to outer alchemy, from love to one another and esteem to one another and surrender that is wanted and brings possessive wanted love. Why do we wear a mask or protect self? Because we want to spare self from being viewed by another person, being wanted by a person who we actually chose. And that is an emotional state, not an obligation, also in many of African countries, and is mutual. The tribe of blue, which is a tribe of males, wears to all formal meetings face covers when married. That marks the difference between a single male and a male that is actually in an active relationship and considered an adult, you see. And that reduces function and communication, not increases it. So again, for instance, for a politician, family and wife is a disadvantage. That person is less likely to perform and less likely to guide objectivism. So what is, do I, if I consume, for instance, in an area where that is a customary meat, do I have to endure sex because the pleasure is such reduced, actually, that it is normatized as a compassionate at best or a personal sacrifice? Well, the answer is actually no. Because it is enough with education and enough with exposure to someone who is more loved, and attending for a person who is a nurse, a boss at work, a person who is a favorite customer, more generous or more concerned or more compassionate mailman. For male, it is the same, a nurse who actually appeared when the male was sick while the wife was resting and expecting care and being won over and over again, which then creates a paradox and basis also for gay relationships. And the answer is, usually the animals have to be cared and provided for the same as other humans to enable happiness on a given area in thriving, so that there is no envy, that one couple works and is unable to have life while another couple is unable to have children because of higher degree of preparation and education, and thus that is expected, forced to satisfy men to do such for free, which is performed voluntarily. But there are limits, and one needs to know that many cases in forensics of nurses killing children or persons killing couples are persons who actually were prevented, and one can try, from wanted sexual relationships, separated by such, by lies marked as sick, and persons started to eliminate or enter in that eros-tanatos dynamic in which whatever one creates, the other one destroys in anger because it is for sake of others. And that is unnatural, we need to understand. And second one is forcing unwanted relationship based on settlement to enable work while persons demean one another behind closed doors, which also brings aggression and family violence and is illegal to